After MSM slams Trump on second day, hero dad saves daughter from being kidnapped using gun. After the liberal media criticized President Donald Trump this week for defending the Second Amendment, one heroic father showed the vital importance of being able to legally own a gun. A father in Florida reportedly prevented his 17-year-old daughter from being kidnapped after he used his gun to scare off the alleged attackers. As reported by the New York Post, the father fired several shots as four suspects attempted to break into his garage. The Okaloosa County Sheriff's Office reported that the four suspects believed the 51-year-old father was wealthy, and devised a plan to rob his home and kidnap his daughter. Deputies said on Tuesday around 10:30 p.m. they responded to a call about a home invasion robbery. The father told deputies that his daughter called him and said someone had blocked the roads to their home with barrels. Police believe the suspects were trying to force the daughter to exit her vehicle and walk to her house. However, the barrels didn't stop the daughter. She drove her car around them and made her way back to her house, according to police. A short time later, her father heard his dogs barking and saw his front motion-activated floodlights come on, the police statement explained. He also heard what sounded like his car door closing and went to get his gun. The father said he fired three shots after he noticed several people were trying to break into his garage. Thankfully, this sent the scared thugs running away into the woods, according to police. Police were able to track down the suspects after a neighbor called with a tip. The Okaloosa County Sheriff's Office uploaded a lengthy statement to their Facebook page Wednesday explaining the entire situation and what evidence they had gathered so far. Check it out below. The four suspects were identified as Keelan Johnson, 19, Austin French, 17, Tyree Johnson, 16, and Kamori Horn, 15. The Post reported that all four suspects have been charged with attempted home invasion robbery and attempted kidnapping. The police statement explained that police found several masks, guns, a knife, a roll of tape, and latex gloves inside the SUV the four teenagers were driving. This scary situation proves President Donald Trump's point. During a news conference Tuesday in Seoul, South Korea, NBC reporter Ali Vitali asked Trump an incredibly leading question about gun control in the wake of Sunday's tragic shooting in Sutherland Springs, Texas, which resulted in the death of 26 people. "If you did what you're suggesting, there would have been no difference 3 days ago," Trump responded. "And you might not have had that very brave person who happened to have a gun or a rifle in his truck go out and shoot and hit him and neutralize him." Trump was referencing Stephen Williford, the heroic man who ran to the church, returned fire at the suspect and engaged in a high-speed chase that ended with the attacker's death. "And I can only say this, if he didn't have a gun, instead of having 26 dead, you would have had hundreds more dead." Exactly. A ban on guns won't keep criminals from obtaining them, but it will keep law-abiding citizens like Williford from protecting his community. While liberals are trying to confiscate guns from law-abiding citizens, both of these heroic men proved exactly why our founding fathers put the Second Amendment in the Constitution. The actions of these two brave men solidify the necessity for guns in the hands of law-abiding citizens.